Hey, what's up guys? FromaGuy01 here and welcome to the NASCAR Fantasy Racing League. Today we have another test race and we are going to be racing at Maggiore East End. It's a new variant of Maggiore in Gran Turismo 7. Now we already did a test race at Daytona, so if you haven't seen that video, I'll link to that below and I highly recommend y'all go watch it. Now we have, I think these guys are going to do about 3 or 4 races here today, so we're going to try to show all of them on YouTube. But this is the first race, so this is truly the first time that these guys are getting out here together with their cars. This clone is going to get hit by the 18 coming to the restart zone. But here we go, coming to the start-finish line. These guys are about to go green at one of the first road course tests for this league. Now again, with Gran Turismo 7, they added a lot of road course variants, as well as some new ones, but let's see what these guys can do as clone is really aggressive, I guess you could say, on the inside. As you can see here, the 18 car is going to try to make a move as clone underbraked a little bit, and yep, there goes the 18. Balthus, one of the new rookies, driving that M&M's 18 test car. He's going to go to the lead. He does have a little bit of an unstable connection because of this game, but you know, still good enough to race. Got Dreitha coming by in his KFC car up to second place. Now, they did run some practice laps just to get some lap times, and I do believe Car Freak was about 4 or 5 tenths ahead of the second fastest guy. He's gonna go to the lead for now. The 18's gonna try to cross him over. That will not work. Oh boy, the 18 car didn't break much. He's gonna go off into the grass. Almost 3 wide for the lead. We just mentioned it. Here comes Car Freak. You hear the turbo screaming on these things when they go by. Yep, Car Freak just bumped the 28, and Car Freak's going to go to the lead very aggressively, but also very quickly. And Dreitha all over Car Freak's bumper. We're going to see what he can do in this corner. So, in the last video, we explained that this league is currently in the off-season right now, because we're all still learning GT7 a little bit, and plus we're trying to see if we can get more drivers to join. So again, we'll be racing Mondays at 7 p.m. Eastern Time, and we'll all be running the BMW M4 Group 4. So we're still looking for drivers, so if you'd like to try out, message CarFreak13 on PlayStation and mention the NFRL when you do, and then we'll have a tryout process where you just have to party chat with him, and then you have to take our cup car out to a track or two and just drive so we can see how good you drive. You must be 18 years or older, and you also need Discord to chat with. If you meet those requirements and you want to join us, please message CarFreak and try out. Car Freak is starting to gap the 55 a little bit. Now the interesting thing here is Car Freak is on Haas, AJ is on Petty GMS, as well as Dreythick. Clone is on DEI, so there's a lot of different teams that brought cars here today to test. And again, as we do this race, AJ spun around, 28's going to try to avoid him, looks like he does. 18 just cut the track to avoid him, but hey, that's what you have to do sometimes. 18 cars in the wall. We're gonna have to hear from NASCAR to see if they wave a yellow for that. Again, with this being a test race, there are gonna be looser rules, so they might not wave a caution every single time that one should be waved. But we do have very strict caution rules for the actual league races. And it looks like, yeah, that 18 crash was not worthy enough for a caution. Now again, we do have other teams right now. They are waiting in the pits, and they are currently just observing this to see what happens. And actually, they will wave a caution. That's interesting. But yeah, I know that Plasma's going to be joining the next race. I do believe that Clint, the Stuart Haas vet, he's going to be coming out into the track eventually too. And again, these teams are just trying to get some handling basics of the car, learn how it drives, get some feedback for some of these courses. And again, if y'all haven't watched the Daytona video, please go take a look at it, because it's really great pack racing. And these guys are going to be doing another test at Daytona under the light, so that should be really fun to watch as well. Looks like these guys might be doing a pit cycle. Nope, they're going to form up now, so they're going to go green this time. Now, I don't really want to, but I think I'm going to for the sake of getting more videos, but I'm going to make all of these test races at Maggiore East End, I'm going to make each one of them their own video. So again, they're going to be shorter, but they're going to be a few more videos, so that should be fun. Coming around to the restart zone, Car Freak is your control car, Dreythick on his outside. See how much he jumps this. Dreythick, wow, yeah, Car Freak just in his own zip code on that restart because nobody went when he did. Three wide for second place there for a split second. Car three almost got taken out by the three, but the three car did a great job diving to the inside, trying to get that momentum. And everybody's going to pan out here. Wow, that 55, he is trying to get to the front. And again, we really don't know what these guys can do, some of these rookies, because Drathic is actually a rookie for Season 2, which will, again, be coming to the channel soon. So y'all haven't seen Drathic race, but trust me when I tell you, he's good. He is very good. And he has joined the newly formed Petty GMS team. As here he comes side by side with Clone, trying to get second. Nope, he backed out of that. That's a dangerous spot to be too wide. Clone trying to hold the line. Drathic is just like, hey man, I need to go. I am quicker than you. Trying to go to the outside, now to the inside, trying to cross him over. Clone is not giving it up, but he's going to have to now. Side by side for second. AJ just punted the three and then punted himself into the grass. Hear him spinning the tires there as Balthus goes way to the outside. And while all this happens, Car Freak is just sailing away. And again, right now with the current season of the NFRL, we are currently in the middle of Season 1 in the playoffs. So we're going to have to show you all of those playoff races, then the championship, and then we have an entire Season 2 to get to, which that's, I think, at least 14 or 15 races. So I'm not sure how long those videos will be, but they will definitely get their time in spotlight because we want to get all of those videos ready to go so you can watch any race of the NFRL on demand. And if everything goes well, we'll have Season 1 and 2 fully ready to go so you can watch it anytime. And again, just lots of great racing between all of our regulars. And I hope to see some of y'all. I hope to see some of you that want to race with us, message Car Freak and try out. Because we are right now nearing full capacity. And full capacity is 16 drivers, you know, so if we could have 16 cars on the field, that would be insane. And you or somebody else joining could be the difference in getting us a full field or having a half field. And as Car Freak comes around that corner really slowly, they have waved a yellow flag, so we will get them formed back up and get ready for a restart. And as the car is coming around the final turn, and Car Freak goes way outside on the final turn, Car Freak and Drathic on the front row, then you got Clone and Balthus in the second row. That 18 car, I'm probably going to say his name wrong, but I will eventually learn it. Here we go, green flag. Drathic got a great restart as Car Freak's going to power by on the inside, but Drathic is still there. Nope, Car Freak's going to take the lead. Wow, the 55 actually lost it on the restart. Clone trying to get around Drathic, but Drathic has a much better drive off. Drathic in the grass a little bit unstable. That's a little sketchy. 18 car is going to try to pass the 3. Wow, he does. Holy crap. Now, I can report that Clone has come on the radio and said that his car just does not feel right. It is outrageously tight going through the sharp corners. But that's what these test races are for. You race in these and you learn. You tune the car up to get them ready for official race day. And again, whenever this league goes racing again, we run legit NASCAR points, NASCAR cautions. Now, there are some things that are going to be different. It is not an exact mimic of NASCAR because we do change some things to try to make the racing environment better. But with that being said, for the most part, we do follow things just like real life NASCAR. And I do believe for season three, we're already in season three. We're going to be doing 15 regular season races. We're going to be doing an all-star race. And if we have enough drivers, we could easily do multiple playoff rounds. For seasons 1 and 2, we had a smaller driver field, so one round of playoffs did it, but again, if we have enough, we'll do two rounds. That should be a lot of fun if we can do it. Clone right now got it back around the 18. He's trying to stay in position. 18 car gave him a little bit of a shot. Again, Clone is bringing out this special Chrome Flames Earnhardt car. And since we're in the off-season, and since we still don't know truly what's going to happen with NASCAR on this game, I'm not really pushing this league to make cars and whatnot, because what if we make a ton of high-end, really nice-looking liveries on this chassis that takes a bunch of time and effort just to have them release a stock car, and then all of a sudden we have to make liveries again on the stock car. So with that, we're just not rushing next season, and plus, we ran seasons 1 and 2 really close together. There wasn't much of an off-season, so now we're just taking a nice break, enjoying Gran Turismo 7, trying to learn it, trying to learn these cars, which is a big enough task. Carfrey goes a little bit to the outside there. Drathic has pretty much sustained his gap over the 3 and the 18. And Carfrey is sailing away. He's in another time zone right now. Drathic's trying to close up if he can. And Clone is fighting this outrageously tight race car. I mean, his car looks tight. His car looks like it's almost not drivable. As I come around this corner, Clone's going to try to once again pass the 18. He keeps letting him get by. He needs to actually maintain that spot. But again, since we have a group of guys on, that is kind of good for that team, though. Get them in traffic and get a feeling for what that car can do right now and figure out what they need to fix on it. And you know what? We didn't do this at Daytona. We might as well do it now, even though these guys are really spread out. But let's do a NASCAR Fantasy Racing League. Crank it up. And with just 1.5 laps to go, you can see here, Carfreak has just an insane gap between him and Drathic in second place. Clearly, the Haas team is pretty dialed in at this track. But again, this is only race one out of about three or four, so we're going to have to see if they can maintain this level of competitiveness in that car. And for these test races, we're also not going to be doing the burnout or the cooldown lap. We're just going to be, you know, showing some highlights after we go over the post race. But here we go. White flag is in the air. One lap to go. The first test race for Maggiore East End. And again, Car Freak being sponsored newly by Peppa Z. That is something that he is being sponsored in with Season 2. And once we get to that moment in Season 2, we'll explain that. But Car Freak is definitely looking fast at this course. And don't forget, right now in NFRL Season 1, he is currently the points leader going into the playoffs. And we are about to have the first playoff race at Mi Abbey, so we can't wait to go there and get that taped. And around the final corner with relative ease, Car Freak is going to win the opening race at Maggiore East End. Great job by him. His car was lightning fast. Nobody could get remotely close to him. As we wait for these other guys to finish, we got Drathic coming in second. AJ's actually going to come up and finish third, as Drathic's going to showboat. Well, Drathic is just going to sit there, so I guess AJ will take third, and then, yeah, bang, right there. So there's the finishing results. Well, that was fun. And as these guys go back to the pits and make some minor adjustments, we will get ready to do another race here, but that will be for another video. Congrats to Car Freak for winning that race, and also these guys, they all had a decent race, just getting some info for their teams. But alright, I want to thank you all for watching, and again, if you haven't seen the Daytona video, go check it out, it's pretty cool. Thank you all so much for watching, and we will see you guys next time on the NASCAR Fantasy Racing League. Hey guys, thank you so much for watching this video. If you liked what you saw, please hit that like button. It really helps out the channel. Don't forget to subscribe if you like what you saw, and if you want to see more content, and switch that notification bell on to get notified every single time we upload a brand new video. And also check the description to get links to all sorts of stuff, including our NASCAR playlist and playlist to funny moments across many other video games. Thank you guys so much, and we'll see you on the next one.